Okay, so this session will covers you the whole CI/CD flow. Okay, so the CI/CD flow means what is the CI? CI means it's a continuous integration process that so every day the developer they have checking the source code into version control system. So once a developer checking the source code into the version control system, then we have to do the CI build. So the CI build, what it will do, so if you want to create any CI job, so first integrate. So let's make it okay. So git integrate with the create a git branch and check out the SOURC source code. Okay, so this is the first task. So this is the task will taken care by, so we will create a branch and so we will hand over that branch to the development team. Development team, they will check out the source code into that particular branch or the repository. So this is the old story that we discussed. Okay, so once we create the branch, check out the source code, we have to do the build activity. Okay, so build activity. So what is the build activity? Integrate, so configure Maven tool with the source code. Okay, so this is one thing. So configure Maven tool means what? So every developer they have written one framework for building their source code. So what is the framework they are using? So nowadays there are a number of frameworks like Ansible, sorry, not Ansible, Maven, Gradle, and there are multiple configuration, I mean multiple technologies that they are going to use for creating a build. Build means what? So build is nothing but what? Finally, so we just compile the source code. Once we compile the source code, we have to build that source code. Once we build the source code, we will get a finally we will get a one what? Finally, we'll get the artifact. Artifact is nothing but what? It's a var, jar, or er files. Okay. So once we create this, once we run the build activity, so finally we will create the var file. Okay. So once we create the var file, so before that, it is a final activity. So on top of this, build the source code with do some sonar code quality check. So what is the sonar code quality? So why we are using this sonar code quality? Why, what is the sonar? Sonar is a code quality technology. So by using this sonar, we can check the quality of the source code. Okay, so what is the quality? Okay, how many lines of that you have written as a developer? How many methods you have created inside your Java file? Okay, so how many comment lines? Okay, what is the coverage of that particular code? So we have to written, we have to configure all these things by using sonar quality technology. So the sonar code quality will do the sonar analysis and it will publish the reports to the development team. Based on the report, they will update, they will get some minor major issues, they will identify some issues and they will fix those issues and they will run the sonar analysis. Okay, so this is for sonar anal part. So CI CD flow. Okay. So once we create, once we run this sonar code quality check, so there are some security scans. Okay, so there are some security scans also. Scans also including here. So security scans. What are the security scans? There is some OSR plugins. Okay, OSR plugins and all, right? So for now this is not required. It's a very simple. So after that, finally we will create a var file. Once var is getting created, then we'll push this var artifact to the Nexus repository. Okay, so we'll publish this artifact to the Nexus repository. So this we have already did. Okay, so this activity is already done. This activity is already completed. So this is not done. This is not required. You can ignore. Okay, this one, do some sonar code check. So this is, I have given you the task. I'm not sure how many people was already done this build activity. So this was already configured. Okay, so this whole process, so we can create it by using what? Jenkins. Okay, so Jenkins, what it will do? Jenkins just create a project. Okay, first one, create a project, configure SCM. SCM means what? Git. Okay, so the next one is configure Maven, then run Maven goals. Okay, once we run the Maven goals, finally push artifact to Nexus. Okay, so this is what, you know, so we can create a as part of CI flow. Okay, CI flow using Jenkins. Okay, so let's go to okay, so this is what you did. Okay, so before this, run the sonar. Okay, so these are the steps that we have created. Okay, so let me start my instances. So my instance is up and running. Okay, so let's get the Jenkins server details now. So this is what the Jenkins machine. So let's paste it and colon. You know how to access the Jenkins from the browser. Okay, so let me log into the Jenkins admin. Right, admin. Okay, so this is what. So meanwhile, let me connect it to the what? My Jenkins console itself. So let me connect it to the terminal. Paste. Okay, so let me log in. Sudo su hyphen Jenkins. Okay, so cd slash app devops. This is the directory. So let me go to the Tomcat role here. So this Tomcat role was created in the last class. Okay, let me check. So my Ansible setup is working or not. You can see so I have one Jenkins server. So this Jenkins server acts as a, so I could not able to log in. Okay, so I'm able to log in. So here you can see I have three instances running on my system, I mean my AWS console. The first one is Jenkins master. This Jenkins master act as a Ansible master itself, and itself my Ansible master server itself act as a node. So I have a couple of other two machines. So one is a T2 medium and T2 micro. So these are the two nodes for my Ansible machine. Okay, so to my Ansible server, let me edit my host entries here. Inventory host, right? So let's, you can see this is my Jenkins Ansible server itself. This is one node, this is a Nexus. Okay, I have to update all these IPs, right? So that let me copy this data into Notepad++. So we can easily edit the, okay. So let me copy my server information from AWS console. Okay, so let's copy, go to here. This is my host name. Let me update it. Okay, so local, next one is node. So let's go to here, update it. Next, copy Nexus server details, I mean Nexus DNS name, and just go to Notepad and paste it here. Okay, so these two are having the same IP. How? This should be different, right? We have three servers. Copy. Let me go to here. Let me delete all this stuff. So let me enter. Paste. Okay. So let me save this. And let me run. Let me check whether my setup is up and running or not. Okay, so you know what is the command to check the connectivity between Ansible master and other nodes. Okay, Ansible hyphen m ping okay ping. So I want to get the inventory information also. Okay, so inventory host space all. So I want to check the connectivity between all the machines. So all three machines were connected. So the Ansible server 0 is my local, my Ansible server. Okay, Ansible 1 is a node 1, this is a node 2, that means this is a Nexus. Okay, Ansible server 2 is the Nexus node. Okay, so let me inventory host. Okay, here you can see Ansible server 2 is my Nexus server. Okay, Nexus server or it's something different. Okay, so what is this IP? Let me check the IP. 238. My IP is 238. Okay, so it's a 238. That's fine. Okay, so now. Okay, so let me run. So before moving to, so I want to provision this Tomcat role. I want to git add. Let me commit these changes. Commit hyphen M server details added. Git push. So let me push these changes to okay. So I'm able to successfully push these changes to remote now. Okay, so let me, so you know how to install this. So I have already written this Ansible role in the previous class. Okay, so let me execute this playbook in one of my node. So my node name is what? So the dev node name is what? This is a 8430 or something. This is the IP. Okay, so group name is dev. Okay, I don't want to install this Tomcat in all these machines. Okay, so how to run this role using Jenkins? Okay, so here you can go to here Jenkins. So here there is a app provision. Okay, so there is one app provision configuration, service app provision. Okay, so let's go to this provision job. Let's see the details of this particular job. So what are the configuration that we did? Okay, so this is I have configured this job in previous class only. Okay, so let me edit this. Okay, so here general section, I don't want to configure anything here. Okay, I just put just leave it the blank here in general section. Just go to source code management. In the source code management, you can see I just configure my Tomcat role. So this is one what? This is one repository in my GitHub account. Okay, so go to GitHub account here. You can see there is one Tomcat role here. Okay, so this is what I configured here. Okay, so let's see. This is credential. This is and all, you know. So I just clone the master branch. Then, so once you configure this, you can go to build section. In the build section, just go to select the invoke Ansible playbook. So if you click this, automatically you will get this information. Okay, so this, you will get this tab. You can see here Ansible installation. So we have to configure Ansible path into the global tool configuration, you know, where we configured our Maven, JDK and Git and all, right? So here workspace, I want to run this playbook. So what is this playbook? Okay, so let me take the clone. Okay, so let me take the clone. So just now I have added some server details, right? So let's take the clone. Okay, so git pull, let me take the pull now. So I just added host entries, right? Let's go to here. Here let me go to the Tomcat role. Okay, so here you can see this is a main AML file. So what is a, here you can see this is a main YML file. So this AML file is having what? So there is one host entry called dev. So what is the dev host entry here? So the dev host entry is what? Our Ansible nodes. So we have total three nodes now. One is the Ansible master and other one is other two is nodes, right? So my Ansible server itself act as a node. Okay. So here I have configured one node. So that is a T2 micro machine. So user is EC2. Okay. Sudo role is Tomcat. Okay. So my role is very simple. So I have written one playbook. This playbook is what? It will download the Tomcat. First it will install JDK. Okay. First it will install the JDK, then create a username and group name. Finally it will download into one temp directory and it will extract that var file into some other location, then create a symlink and change the ownership and configure the Tomcats. Okay, I have some configuration files in template folder. Okay, so in template for all, what are the server.xml? Okay, for example, in future, I don't want to run my Tomcat using what? 8080. Okay, so I want to change my username here to 8090. So here, go to default main section. So I want to change here to 9090. Okay, so here we can change it and commit the changes, and our Tomcat will start working on this 9090 port. Okay, I will make those changes. So this is what the simple playbook that I have written in the last class. So now I am going to execute this Tomcat role from, I just want to clone this role from the Git and trying to execute that role from Ansible playbook, sorry, Jenkins. Okay, so let's run this job once. So let's see the output. So what it will do? So now it start running the Tomcat. Okay, so this job is successfully completed. Now go to, this is the node, this is IP of that particular machine. Okay, I'm just copying the IP from my node entry. So let's go to here, just paste it and 8080. Let's enter. So my Tomcat is up and running. So my Tomcat provisioning is done. Okay. So next. So as I already given one role, that role name called what? Install one Tomcat server, one Sonar server using Ansible, any of the nodes. This is what one, this is the task that I have given. Okay. So let's discuss about the task. Okay. So first, as per our previous discussion, right? So we have to, so this setup is already ready. Okay, first two points were already, so we have created Jenkins job for the same. So the second point, so third point I'm going to configure it now. Okay, third point. So if you want to run the Sonar analysis, first we should install the Sonar. So we can install Sonar in okay, so I have covered all the first two points. Okay, so now I am going to configure this one. So this is already given as a task to you guys, but I don't know how many guys are completed. Okay, let me do this. Okay, so let me skip this, this is not required. So the fourth point is also done. Okay, so fifth point is also done, because so my Nexus server is already ready. Okay, so if you want to check, you can check now. Okay, let's go to here, just copy this IP or domain name, copy, go to browser and paste it here. So what is the port? 8081. Let's enter. So here Nexus. Okay, so let me open the Nexus. Okay, even my Nexus is also configured, right? So one activity that is pending for what? It's a Sonar. Okay, so let me create a role for Sonar. Yeah, so now I want to create one role for what? Provisioning the sonar on one of my node. Okay, so here the role structure is same. You can see the role structure is same. Default, in the default we have what? Variables. Handler means what? For restarting sonar. Meta, so this is for just some user information. Okay, so this is some user information. So next, this is a task. Task is the main section in the role. So task section, go to main YML file. So this YML file having what? So create a database. So first of all, first create a database for sonar. So I have parameterized all. Sonar is a Java application. Okay, so in your system JDK must be up and running. So without JDK sonar, it can't be, it cannot be, we cannot able to up and running. So here you can see sonar requirement, server minimum with 1 GB or 1 CPU capacity or something. Okay, so that is for just minimum. We need a T2 medium machine. Okay, don't try with the micro, so that should not work actually. Okay, so need any database. Okay, so database is it required? Ideally it should not required, because sonar itself having its own default database. For our demo set, demo purpose and all, default database is enough. JDK. So all sonar cube processor as a non sonar user, it's not a root. Okay, so for example, if you are trying to install sonar, but let's say if you are trying to download one sonar from Linux machine using root, you can extract and you can start the sonar. So ideally this is not a best practices to run any process or any DevOps tools. We should not install any DevOps tool using root. Okay, you can create your own user. Okay, then you have to install that particular technology. So it's very simple. First, sudo m install update. Okay, this step 1, step 2, step 3 is not required for us. Why? Because so we have already run wget, ngip, everything we have already run into our system. Okay, so the next one is openjdk is also installed. Next one, set up the PostgreSQL. Okay, this is the steps that we have following. Next, just create a database for sonar. Okay, so this is one task name that I have defined. So this task name is what? There is one module, that module name called what? MySQL DB. So MySQL DB is one module name. Okay, so as we discussed, right, so out of 40 modules, this is one of the important module. Okay, so here I have just parameterized, I just declare the variable here, sonar MySQL database. This is one variable. So where we declared this variable, do you know? So here it is in default section. Default section, so in the default section MySQL, let's copy this and go to default section. Let's search it for this variable. Okay, so let's search for this variable. So here my database name is what? Sonar. Okay, here you can see workspace is slash root or something, forget about workspace. Okay, sonar download validity sets, yes, let's put this sonar version. So what is the version that I am going to use? I'm trying to download sonar 5.6.6. so what is the URL? Okay, let's copy this URL and paste it in the browser. Okay, so let's copy this. So I just make it all the variables. Okay, so whatever the, you know, hard coded values that I'm going to put, so everything I just put it as a variable. Okay, so sonar cube is not running. Let's go to distribution. Maybe this path has changed. Let's see, download sonar cube. Okay, so let's go to here, download sonar cube. I don't want to install the latest version. Let's go to the old version. Okay, so here long term version LTS, so all the versions. Okay, what is the version that we are using? 5.6.6, right? So 5.6.6. So let's go to this. Here you can see this is a, so let's go to show all. Let's copy link address and paste it in this particular location. Okay, so here I want to make this version as a parameter. I don't want to put any hard coded values here. Okay, so let's put this version name as a, let me create interpolation here. So let's see. Paste. Okay, so this is the version that I am using. So once we call this variable, it will search for this variable and value of this variable. The value is 5.6. This is the latest version that I am downloading. Sonar version directory. So sonar cube hyphen version. It will create a directory name with version. Okay. So sonar MySQL name, username, sonar MySQL password, sonar. Okay. MySQL host, local host, sonar port. I mean MySQL port. MySQL is running on port 3306. My database name is sonar. Okay. So these are the different variables that I have configured in my default section. Okay, so handler means it is just a configuration that we, you know, created for, you know, restarting the sonar. Okay, let's go to the task section. Task here, create a sonar username. Okay, so create a sonar username. So my SQL underscore user name, my SQL username, host name, items. Okay, so with items handle we will discuss later. Okay. So next, download sonar. Get URL is a module to download any libraries from the Google, so we can use the get URL. So URL is what? Sonar download URL. Okay, let's go to here, main default. What is the download URL? This is URL. Maybe future, so if you want to change the version of sonar, so we don't want to change all my playbook here. I don't want to change, for example, right now I am putting this version in one place. Okay, for example, if you put odd coded values in all this playbook, right? So if you want to change something, okay, so if you want to change some version of the sonar, if you put those values, odd coded values in your task main YML file, I mean task file, okay, main YML file, so it will be very difficult for you to identify that version and change that version name and all. That's why I just make those hard-coded values as a parameters here. Parameter is nothing but what? I just declare some variables. So declare variable is nothing but it's a key value pair. For example, if you want to change some version in future, let's say I want to change the version to 6 point or 8 point or something. Okay, in future, you just download this role and update the version here. So this version will update everywhere in your role. Okay, so this is the beauty of the Ansible variables. Okay, so let's save this, go to here, next, unzip. So it is an archive is a module to unzip. Very simple. First download the sonar from the Google, extract it and move to sonar one place. Just go to here, move to user local to some, it will moving to some other directory. This is the shell module. Okay, so include configuration YML. Just go to the configuration YML. So here, this configuration YML is very simple. Okay, what is the configuration YML file that? Because why we are configuring this? For example, if you want to, by default, Sonar come up with the default database. Okay, so if you want to update your Sonar with the custom database, so we can configure this. You can copy this content to this particular sonar property file. Okay, so that is why I just create a configure.yml file. Okay, so let's go to the template. sonar. So this is what? This is just as a script file. So what this will do? This script file will do just to start and stop the sonar. Okay, so this will finally moving to, let's go to the main YML file. Okay, so where is the notify template? Here you can see template folder. In template folder, what is the file name? Sonar.unity.j2. So this will copy to etcd systemd system. It's copies as a service file. Okay, this will automatically renamed while copying the file to template folder to target server. Okay, so just change the permissions and all. Okay, so just, so these are, so by default you can see the port is what? 9000. So we can make this port is also, we can declare this port as a in variable sections also. Here we can put this port here also, because sonar is always running the port number 9000. Okay, that is why I put that value as an hard coded value. Okay, so this is what the simple playbook that I have written. So let's go to inventory section here. Okay, so go to host. Here I can see only one host. Let me copy this data, copy, paste it here. Okay, I want to configure all the three servers, but I don't want to install my sonar in all three servers. I want to install, you know, install my sonar in where? My T2 medium machine, that is an Nexus machine. So now I want to install, already my Nexus is installed in this particular machine, but on the top of the same machine, I'm trying to install sonar as well. Okay, so now my sonar and Nexus are in same machine. Okay, so go to here. Let me change this host to Nexus. User remote sudo becomes yes. Sudo, this is the role that we configured. Okay, so let's commit these changes to where? Let's go to git status. Okay, so these are the files that I have modified. Okay, so let's git add commit hyphen added sonar role. That's it. Okay, git push, let push the changes to the remote. My code is being pushed to the my GitHub repository. Okay, so let's go to GitHub repository. Let's go to here. Where is this role? Let's go to here. Sonar role. Okay, so this is my role. Copy this. Let's go to here. Write one sonar sonar provisioning. Okay, so let me copy the service app provision or something. Okay, so I don't want to create all SEM and all, right? So let me update the role name here. Okay, so let's go to here. This is playbook. I just want to copy the configuration from where? Existing playbook, existing Jenkins job. Okay, so here I want to change the role name called sonar hyphen role. Okay, so branch name is same master. Let me go to this section here. What is the ML file here? Sonar.yml file inventory. I just specify the inventory also. Let's save this and paste it. Okay, Let's run this Jenkins job and see. So it is getting fail because Ansible 2 server required module PSQL Python. Create a sonar database, change it to fastness. Okay, so let me log into that machine first and check what is the issue. Let me log in. Okay, so Nexus. So let's go to here. Sudo m update all. Okay, no package. Sudo m install mysql. Okay, but this package is there now, but why it is not running? Let's check here YML file. Where is the task YML file? Create a database for Sonar. Okay. Let's go to here. Let's install MySQL. Okay, let me execute this sonar job once again. Create a database, Ansible server fail. So let's do one thing. I'm going to remove these two tasks. Okay, so let's say I'm going to run my sonar using default database. Okay, so let's try to commit this change. So we will fix that issue, no problem. Because it is trying to create a database, but there is no MySQL because I have installed MariaDB. Okay, so I have to add few more tasks here. Okay, so let me rerun the job. So it is trying to download the sonar. You can see, so where it will download the sonar, it's under root. Okay, sudo su slash root. Let's check. So what is the version? It's a 5.6.7, that is the version name that we are using, right? So moving to sonar one place, rejects and control C. Why we are putting control C and all, right? Okay, let's see what is the task that we are running. Hello sonar build time to start. Okay, let's go to here, control F. Okay, so it will wait and then link will change. 180 seconds. 180 seconds means it's a 3 minutes of time. Okay, so let's wait, then it will automatically provision this one. Okay, so let's see here, let's change the time also. 60 seconds, let's put 1 minute time. Okay, so so there must be some issue with the database here. Okay, so we have to remove the database configuration and restart, reinstall the sonar, reprovision the sonar. Okay, so let's go to here. So it will take some amount of time. Okay, and it got success. So let's go to here. PS minus F, grab sonar. Let's start the sonar then manually. -100. Okay, so let's start the sonar. Starting the web. Okay, process is closed. That means this is not running properly. Okay, so connection refused. Java refused. Communication, the driver has not any packet from the server. Let's see. Create a pool. Okay, this is not there. Okay, the same exception. Okay, so let me figure out. Let me pause this video. You can see, so what is the exception that we are getting previously? So there is a connectivity issue between. So once I create the role, right? So I'm trying to install that role into one of my machine. So initially I have removed some MySQL configuration, right? So initially I'm trying to create the database. Okay, so even we have to add those two tasks in that particular YAML file here also, because here what I deleted here, so first it will create a database and database name. Okay, so if you want to create a database, first you should install the MySQL database into your Linux machine. Okay, so to create a MySQL database, it's time taking process. That's why I remove those two tasks from my YAML file. So now I am trying to install my sonar, plain sonar. I don't want to configure any database, so my sonar itself using my own database. That's why I removed the whole MySQL configuration, my ansible playbook, and again rerun the job. My job is getting successful. Finally my sonar is coming up. You can see the logs here also. So once you can see the process is up, that means what? So my sonar is up and running with the port number 9090. Here you can see the port. See, HTTP connector enabled on port 900. You can copy this IP, system IP, a DNS name. You can run it and you can see the sonar is installed successfully. But how this sonar server is coming up without database? Because I am not using any custom database like MySQL, PostgreSQL, MariaDB or Cassandra, any other custom DBs. I am not using any custom databases, but I am using sonar database itself. Sir, how you know my sonar is using custom database itself? Okay, not custom database, how sonar is up and running? Okay, so here you can see by default every sonar, okay, so they have their own embedded database. Now you can see there is some letters highlighted in the red color, light red color. You can see embedded database should be used only for evaluation purpose. Okay, evaluation means what? Demo purpose. Okay, so if you want to log into the Sonar, you can use admin. Admin is the username, admin is the password. Okay, so you can see this is my username and password. So here there are dashboards, issues, quality gates, quality, okay, quality profiles. Let's very important, quality profiles. What are the quality profiles we have? So there are some quality profiles for the technology related. So if you are running the Sonar analysis for C sharp or C hash, okay, so this will be the quality profile. For example, if you want to use the Java, we have a default Java. So we have default Java profile. So by default Java, we having 250 rules, 254 rules we have. Okay, so in real time, okay, so these 250 rules will not sufficient for our project. So we have to update this Sonar rule set as well. So who will give you the rule set? As a developer, development team, they will give you the rule set. So we have to upload that rule set into our Sonar. Okay, so that is a different story. We will discuss after some time. But now I want to configure this Sonar into, I want to integrate my Sonar with what? Maven. Okay, so let's go to here. So this is my service app. What? This is my service app. So this is service app. I want to integrate my Sonar with my project. This is my source code. Okay, so I am in master. So I want to configure my Sonar with what? Maven. Okay, so let's go to the pom.xml here. Here, this is a pom.xml. So here you can see this section, profile section. The profile name is what? Sonar. Okay, so property Sonar host name is what? So this is what I want to update. Okay, so this is what the Sonar information. I just update the host URL here. Okay, so let's note this. This is the Sonar code quality. So this is what the configuration. So who will update this configuration in source code? Sometimes, most of the cases, development team, they will configure all these settings. But what is our job? So we have to share this URL. Once we install Sonar, so once the Sonar is up and running in our system, okay, then you have to share that URL and they will configure this URL into their source code. Sometimes they will configure RL, you can configure it by your own also. Okay, so let me save this change and commit this change. Okay, so let's go to git status. So what is pom.xml I have modified, right? So let me so this is what the Sonar configuration that I did in pom.xml. Even same thing, I want to add my repositories, Nexus repository is also here. So this is my Nexus repository. So let me log in my Nexus repository, admin. Admin, then admin 123. Let's try to run login. Okay, so I'm able to log in. Let's go to here. So I have a couple of repositories here. Okay, so let's copy this snapshot URL. Okay, so copy link address. So I want to configure my Sonar. So where I want to configure my Sonar? So not Sonar. So where I want to configure my Nexus? Nexus by default we have to configure in Maven home location. Inside Maven home location there is a conf directory. So inside conf directory, so we have a sectin.xml file. So we can configure that Nexus details into sectin.xml in the Maven home directory. Okay, so let's go to here. Where is the Maven pom sectin.xml? So I have already created some custom sectin.xml. You can copy this custom.xml into your Maven home conf directory. Okay, so let's update this. Okay, so save this, but I won't commit this file. Okay, so this file is present in where? Conf directory. Okay, so let's copy this data. Okay, let's save this and commit these changes. Okay, so git status. Okay, so I want to commit only form.xml. I don't want to commit any setting.xml. Okay, and just git add form.xml. Okay, form.xml. Okay, git add form.xml. Okay, let's git commit -m update this sonar details in the form.xml. Okay, so git push. Okay, so let me okay, so this is what the sonar configuration that we updated. Okay, so